we're talking about the Fabulous Poodles. When I was about 12 years old, I was introduced to a wonderfully weird record album. At the time, the biggest sellers were records like Billy Joel's 52nd Street, the Bee Gees' Spirits Have Flown, Zeppelin's In Through the Outdoor, and some god-awful collection of Barbra Streisand's Most Atrocious. The Fabulous Poodles were like none of them. These days, when people ask me about the Fabulous Poodles, I say they're almost like England's answer to Devo, except a lot more analog. I think they saw themselves as more aligned with bands like The Kinks or The Who. They had some really clever songs with some wry humor like Bionic Man, Anorexia, and an Everly Brothers cover of Man With Money.
She wants a man with lots of money.
They were funny, but they weren't a comedy act. I'm not sure how you'd classify them, and neither was Dick Clark.
I never thought I would see the day in my life when a rock band would have an electric mandolin, electric guitar. I mean, that's unique. What is that? It's a violin? What is that? That's a violin. What is this?
It's a mandolin.
Oh, I thought I said that. I made the terrible mistake of saying, how did you get together? And was it you said through a dating service? What's the real answer? How did you get together?
It was a dating game.
Come on. Are you insane?
Am I insane?
No, the group in total.
No, not really. We're just a bunch of four lovely, wonderful guys.
Starting in 1975, they developed a UK touring act that landed them gigs opening for the likes of Meatloaf and Chuck Berry. They also became famous English DJ John Peel's favorite group. Between 1977 and 1979, they released three albums, The Fabulous Poodles, Unsuitable, and Think Pink, with only the last one being available in the USA. Prior to Think Pink, selected songs from the first two albums were compiled into an American release called Mirror Star. That landed at number 61 on the US music charts, and back in those days, that took some impressive numbers. I mean, now you could get on the charts. The band consisted of guitarist and singer Tony DeMure, violin and mandolin player Bobby Valentino, bassist Richard C. Robertson, and drummer Bryn Burrows. A fifth member of the band, pianist Bob Suffolk, was apparently chiefly responsible for talking them into recording, but before the albums came out, he left the group to make a very successful career designing recording studios. The first album was produced by John Entwistle, and their live act included things like Unicycles, a dog that barked at the harmonica, and exploding mandolins. Also, Valentino played his electric violin into a talk box like he was Peter Frampton. In January of 1979, they set out on a US tour to support acts like the Ramones and Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. They headed back to the UK for a break in April, playing a show at the Paris Theatre in London, and then returned to the US in November of that year to continue touring. Their last show was at the Bottom Line in New York on February 4th, 1980. Unfortunately, Think Pink didn't match the success of Mirror Stars, which is unfortunate because it's a way better album. It peaked at 185 on the album charts. After releasing their final single, Stomping on the Cat, in 1980, the band parted ways, and apart from a few one-off gigs between members, they haven't played together since. Drummer Bryn Burrows went on to play with bands like Underworld and the seriously weird Frewer. Later with Dead Man's Corner, and most recently he's played drums for a band called Men With Ven.
Incredible, a spectacle, the people are hospitable.
Singer and guitarist Tony DeMure created a comedy act with the stage name Ronnie Golden. He also had a band called Ronnie and the Rex, and he played Buddy Holly on an episode of The Young Ones.
Oh, Buddy Holly!
That's right. You know, I just love your English Beatles. Mind you, after 20 years of the suckers, I ain't got much choice.
Valentino and Robertson joined the folk country band The Electric Bluebirds for a while. Valentino is a well-regarded studio musician. He's released three albums of his own, and most recently he's been with an Americana act called Los Pistoleros.
I'm swinging with the chickens today.
Robertson went on to play bass for country act Hank Wangfield, and then later for Barrence Whitfield and the Monsters.
She's a girl from outer space!
All the Fabulous Poodle albums were released together as a box set last year. No vinyl, bummer, but at least there are CDs and Amazon streaming. I can now tell Alexa to play the Fabulous Poodles, and she does it. I'm Christopher, you're awesome. Thanks for watching. Stay out of the comfort zones.